Hello friends, welcome back to my beautiful gardening life, and today is this plant. This plant is called as the philodendron cherry red, and you rightly guessed it why it's called as the cherry red. If you observe this new leaf that has come out of this catapult, it looks so wonderful and rich red. After that, it goes a slightly bronze color, and as the leaf matures, it becomes dark green. It looks wonderful, wonderful to look at. This philodendron is a self-heading variety. Now, when I'm saying that, I mean that it's not a climber. You don't require a moss, a pole for it, so that it requires its support to climb. It is a self-heading, so the leaves are going to be like very close together to the stem. It is like, you know, a flower, you can say, of red, orange and dark green leaves when it initially starts off with this lovely new leaf. As you know that philodendrons are very easy to care for, so it is likewise a philodendron cherry red also. It requires this bright indirect sun if you are growing it indoors, but in case it is grown outdoors, see that it keep it in direct sunlight for more than 2 hours. The soil requirement is that it requires well draining soil, so every time you water, the water should just like gush out from the pot, so the soil is like well draining with equal amount of river sand, vermicompost and garden soil. With regards to its propagation, as I said, they're self-heading variety. So when I'm saying it, if it was a climber, you could easily propagate. But when they are all clung together, propagation gets a little difficult. But if it grows to a considerable amount of height, then propagation could be through stem cuttings. For watering this plant, you have to check if the topmost layer of the soil is dry. Then only you'll go ahead and water it. For fertilizing, what I do is every month I just add a handful of vermicompost, which is an organic fertilizer, to the pot, so that gives it the required fertilizing. This plant does not require pruning, but as and when the new leaf shoots out, there would be this dead leaves or drooping leaves which can be trimmed off to give it a very neat look. Also, I should mention that this plant likes to be misted. So if you mist it maybe once a week, it will help to keep the leaves clean also. Misting also helps to check in case there are some insects or pests resting on the leaves or on the underside of the leaves. It helps to wash them off. So misting does help for every plant. I think I've mentioned everything about this plant to care it to the max. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you are really impressed with this plant, please look out for it in the nursery and try to add it to your collection. Thank you so much for watching. I see you again.